Hello.
Hi there.
I'm Jay.
I'm Mervyn. Nice to meet you.
Dom?
Metal worker Dominic Chenier is just the man to knock this rundown roadster back into shape.
Wow.
What is it? What's the history behind it?
It's a go-kart, obviously three-wheeled.
When did you get this?
About 1959. This was just all red, gleaming, under the Christmas tree. Couldn't wait to get on it, you know. I think there was a few chunks taken out the doors as I went through them, but it took a while to master, you know. And when I got outside of it, you know, you saw low down and speeding along.
And the wind in your heart.
Not much left now, but...
I can see it in your eyes. As soon as we start talking about your childhood with this, you just light up.
Oh, yes.
And it's been special ever since you've got it.
It's been ridden by everybody in the family, nephews and nieces. My own children.
Yeah.
Everybody just had fun on it. It's getting to the point now where I'd like to see if I can get something done so my grandchildren can
go on
it. Because it is getting a bit, I wouldn't say dangerous.
Dangerous, but, I think, you know, safe to say, It's such an unusual looking thing. I've never seen anything like this.
On the rear tyre, it does mention Lyons Brothers, who were the forerunners of Triang.
Okay.
So I don't know whether it was an early Triang toy. I don't know.
A hint of a sticker here.
Yes.
Triang was a 20th century toy manufacturer, owned by three toy magnates, the Lyons brothers.
I don't see a steering wheel on this. So how does it work?
Put your feet on the and steer with your feet.
Dangerous, isn't it?
It is.
So I get you sit on the seat, your feet steer. But what's this? A brake?
No. It is a brake, but it's also the mechanism to make it go.
Okay.
And also the brake.
So you can kind of
go like that. And that.
Yeah. If you lift it up.
Oh, so that moves the back wheel.
Cranks around and moves the back wheel.
So you can get back up the hill again?
Yes. Yeah. And if you want to stop, you just reverse. And then stops.
Oh, that's very clever, isn't it?
That is quite
simple.
Smart.
Yeah.
What would you like us to do to it?
The main is the seat and the seating area.
Okay.
And the wheels.
These are not the original wheels, are they?
No, they're not the original wheels. The original front wheels were similar to this.
Okay. So how come they're replaced?
It just got so worn. And the spindles broke. My father, he found some, I think, the pram wheels.
Yeah.
Obviously, it used to be red.
If it could come back to being red again, that would be ideal. And whether you can roll the seat
we'll
up
do
and
our best.
Things like that.
But importantly, it's just, it's going to work again.
Yes, and make it safe.
Make it safe, to use again.
Yes.
Great.
So, Dom, what do you reckon?
I think it's brilliant.
Yeah?
I love it. I'm jealous, yeah.
Me too.
Yeah.
I want to have a go, man.
I know. There's a fair bit to do. There is a fair bit to do. It has obviously had a lot of use.
Yeah.
It has a lot of use.
Yeah.
Everybody's loved it.
Thank you for bringing this along.
Thank you. Lovely to meet you.
Thanks, now.
OK.
The state it's in now is a bit sad because I've had so much enjoyment and a lot of other people have had a lot of enjoyment out of it and it's got tatty. It wants a little bit of TLC.
You know what? This will give you oodles of fun, though, wouldn't it?
I would have loved to have this when I was a kid. Absolutely loved it.
So, a lot of the stuff is quite...
It's not too bad. It's not too bad at all. It needs to come apart completely. Yeah. There's a lot of bits that are just worn. I think it's just been well used and loved. And, you know, it's done its job.
It has done its job.
So it's just a case of obviously finding new wheels.
Yep, cool.
And then we'll try and have a look at this seat, which is going to be a bit of a tricky job, to be honest with you.
As you said, it's done its job. Now it's your turn.
Thanks, Jay.
Thank you.
I need to break down all of the components into each individual piece and then assess them for damage and wear. And there's also little interesting things. I think as I take it apart, the more I'm sort of having a look, there's chips in the paint. I think we'll uncover some of the history of this red paint. There's hints of like old stickers. So I'm quite looking forward to getting it apart and seeing what's underneath all of this dirt and muck. So I've got the go-kart completely apart now. It's actually come apart quite well, which I'm really relieved about. There's an awful lot of red paint creeping through underneath this black overpaint. Quite curious if I can take off this layer of black paint to see if there's enough red paint on there that maybe we could try and save it. It's really exciting doing this. I mean, you can already see how that vivid red is just coming through already, and I've not even really just started. I can just only imagine how excited Mervyn must have been on that Christmas morning when he saw this gleaming red go-kart under his tree.
Triang toys like this were the envy of children in the 1950s. In their heyday, Triang were the biggest toy factory in the world, producing train sets, go-karts, and model cars until the 1970s.
I'm really pleased I'm going to be able to preserve the original paint on Mervyn's go-kart.
A sympathetic restoration means filling in the worst areas of paint loss with a precisely matched colour.
It's a quite slow process, just touching in all of the chips and damage, but being quite selective about how far to go. These are all kind of battle scars from Mervyn's trips down the hills when he was a kid, and I think it would be such a shame to paint over all of that history.
Essential to any go-kart, the wheels. And sharing the outdoor workshop with bike guru Tim has its advantages.
Tim, have you got a second?
Yeah, certainly.
Just, what do you think about this? This is Mervyn's go-kart. He wants to hand it on to his grandkids and they want to use it.
All right.
My concern is this wheel. I don't know what to do. Obviously, it needs to be safe.
From a safety point of view and structurally, I would replace all the spokes.
You think we have to replace them all?
Yes, absolutely. All right, no worries.
Brilliant. Thanks, Tim.
Cheers.
Wheels work by sending force out from the hub to the rim via the spokes. After years of compression and stretch, the spokes lose tension and wheels get wobbly, which is where Tim comes in.
What spokes do, they basically allow you to straighten the wheel up. I can true the wheel up and down and also side to side like that and get it central.
Truing like this means the wheel holds its shape perfectly as it spins.
You can't beat a good hand-built wheel.
A new solid rubber tyre is fashioned and fitted.
OK, I'm happy with that. One wheel.
Meanwhile, Dom is dealing with the damaged seat.
So it's basically just isolating the broken area. I'll cut this out, and this should just leave me with a nice, clean square. Now the old damaged area has been removed, I just need to shape a new piece, weld it in and grind it back. You'll never know that we've been in there. So this is a really critical part of the repair. It's so important that it's strong. Welding work's now complete on the seat. It's now structurally sound, which is great. I'm just cleaning it up to paint, and I'm amazed, absolutely amazed. Almost two-thirds of the seat is actually this beautiful original colour green. I've got a fantastic colour match to that green, so I'm going to be able to introduce that colour onto the top very carefully. Just don't want it to look like I've just replaced it for a brand new seat.
Hi. Lovely to see you again. Yeah, who have you brought along?
This is Rowan, grandson.
And Willow.
Hello. Hey.
Hello.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
Do you remember what you brought along?
I remember the heap of rust. It was falling to bits. And I'm hoping you managed to do something with it, so at least it's rideable.
Yeah. I'm so excited to show you. I can't wait. You ready?
Oh, yeah. Wow. Green seat as well. Yeah. I can remember the green seat.
You can?
Yeah, I remember it. Yeah, just like it was. Proper wheels.
Is it?
This is amazing.
Yeah.
Is it how you remember that Christmas morning?
It is how I remember that Christmas morning. Came down, saw this, all shiny under the tree.
Most of this is the original paint that was underneath.
Was it? Over.
I've not actually had to repaint very much at all yet, even the green. It's been so much fun uncovering all the little histories, the little badge and all the, you know, all the colours. It's been it's been an absolute pleasure to work on this.
So. Yeah. So it was a Triang then?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I love
it's
it.
Amazing.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Do you want to try it out?
Yes.
Yeah? Should we take it outside?
Great, miss. Thank you.
Hey!
Brilliant.
To see them riding on the go-kart, it's like a continuation of families and hopefully we can go and pass it further down generations. Well, that's great.
Very good.
It's nice to see somebody else having the enjoyment out of it.
Look at that. She's good.
She is good.
It was even better than I was hoping for.
I think it's amazing.
I think she can ride it better than I did.
Yeah.
Is that good?
Yeah.
I only wish that I could fit on it and I could have a go, because I certainly got a lot of enjoyment out of it.